Dear students, I am going to discuss the second problem on divisible by k problems of DFA, that is draw a DFA to accept decimal strings divisible by 3. So here decimal strings divisible by 3, then what is the radix r here? R is equal to 9, sorry it is 10, that is starting from 0 to 9, all the digits from 0 to 9. Okay, it is decimal digits divisible which are divisible by 3. So the numbers from 0 to 9 totally radix is of 10. Okay, then what is my d here? D can be digits from 0 to 9. So radix is what? From 0 to 9 we have 10 and digits are from 0 to 9. And what is my k? K is 3. So to draw the DFA for this, what I do to find the transition from one state to the another state, I will take the possible remainders of k, that is I. Remainders is represented as I. I is equal to what? Possible remainders of 3 are 0, 1 and 2. So I substitute in the formula to find the transition, that is from the state qi, I is the remainder, on reading 0. It moves to some new state, that is I should find qj. Qj, how to identify qj here? I should find what is j. J is equal to ri r into I plus d mod k. If we go with the formula method, what we should do? For each input symbol, taking the remainder I as 0, 1, 2 and changing the digits from 0 to 9, I should find what is qj by substituting in this formula where r value is 10 and I value keeps on changing. I may take 0, then 1, then 2 and this d will be taking 0 to 9 inputs. So then what is the value I am getting? For all the 10 input symbols I should compute. So what happens? The complexity of the problem increases. It becomes very big. So instead of going like this, so one shortcut method to solve this problem is, okay guys, instead of doing like this, we'll follow a shortcut method to construct the DFA. So as I told in the first problem, the shortcut method is, first take the possible remainders. It is divisible by 3, right? Note down the remainders of 3. Remainders of 3 are 0, 1 and 2. It means the DFA has 3 states, Q0, Q1 and Q2. Now try the transition table first. Okay guys, write the transition tables. The alphabet set, it is what? Accept decimal strings. Decimal strings starts from 0 to 9. So construct the DFA. 0, the input symbols 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 input symbols we have. Write all the 9 input symbols. Okay guys. Then what are the states we have? States is equal to possible number of remainders. 0, 1, 2. So it means we have 3 states. Q0, Q1 and Q2. Name the states as Q0, Q1 and Q2. Okay guys, first we'll write the transition table. After writing the transition table, seeing that we'll write the DFA, the easiest method. So here, without changing the sequence, you should be very careful that you write all the numbers starting from 0 to 9 continuously without interchanging. And this also should be in a sequence. Like a cycle, you should start from 0, Q0, Q0, Q1, Q2, write horizontally. Repeat the same sequence, Q0, Q1, Q2. Again repeat, Q0, Q1, Q2. Again, Q0, Q1, Q2. Continue to the next row. Q0, Q1, Q2. Q0, Q1, Q2. Similarly, fill the entire transition table. Here also Q0 only. So horizontally you fill Q0, Q1, Q2, Q0, Q1, Q2, Q0, Q1, Q2. So once the table is, transition table is ready, we can easily construct the DFA. Now which is our starting state? Q0 is our starting state. How to identify the final state? Divisible by 3 means what? The numbers should be exactly divisible by 3. Which are multiples of 3 are divisible by 3. The remainder is 0. The remainder is 0 is in which state? It is 0 in the Q0 state, because Q0 represents remainder 0. And Q1 represents all the states with remainder 1. And 2 represents all the input symbols with remainder 2. That is state Q2. So Q0 itself is our final state. Then how to construct the DFA for this? See here guys, Q0 on 0. Construct the DFA now. Q0 on 0. It is going to Q0 itself. Self loop. Q0 on 1. It goes to Q0 on 1. It goes to Q1. Then Q0 on 2, 2. It goes to Q0 on 2 to Q2. So I am taking Q2 here. So Q0 on 2 to, it is going to Q2. Then Q0 on 3 to Q0. Q0 on 3 to Q0. Q0 on 4 to Q1. See here, Q0 on 4 to Q1. Already 1 we have written, now 4 is coming. Then Q0 on 5 to Q2. Q0 on 6 to Q0. Q0 on 7 to Q1. Q0 on 8 to Q2. Q0 on 9 to Q0. Okay guys. Then similarly fill for Q1. Q1 on 0. Q1 on 0 to Q1. Q1 on 1 to Q2. Q1 on 1 to Q2. Q1 on 2 to Q0. Q1 on 2 to Q0. To Q0. Q1 on 3 to Q1. Q1 on 4 to Q2. Q1 on 5 to Q0. Q1 on 5 to Q0. Q1 on 6 to Q1. So like this, if you fill, finally you will end up with like this 1, 4, 7 you will get. And here also you will get 2, 5, 8. Similarly, Q2, Q2 on 0 to Q2. Q2 on 1 to Q0. Q2 on 1 to Q0. Then Q2 on 2 to Q1. Q2 on 2 to Q1. So here you will get 1, 4, 7, and here you are going to get after filling 0, 3, 6, 7, and here also you got 2, 5, 8, and here also you will get 2, 5, 8, Q2 on Q1. So this is a DFA, you are going to, and Q0 is our starting state and Q0 itself is our final state. Okay guys. This is a DFA to accept decimal strings divisible by 3. See how easily I constructed. This will accept only the decimal strings which are divisible by 3. Apart from, see, if you give decimal number 1 or 4 or 7, 1 mod 3 or 4 mod 3 or 7 mod 3, the remainder is 1. So from here it goes to the state Q1 or it will go to the state Q2, but Q1 or Q2 are not final states. So strings of decimal numbers 0, 3, 6, 9, if you see, only they will be accepted in the final state. So this is one of the easy method we follow to construct the DFA whenever divisible by K problems are given. Hope you have understood. Please subscribe, like, share and comment. Thank you.